This video is about Iran versus the Sunni Gulf states. Iran and Saudi Arabia are mortal enemies. Before the United States invaded and conquered Iraq in 2003, removing Saddam Hussein from power, prior to that, these two kept each other in check. Iraq and Iran fought a very devastating war in the 1980s, and they were both afraid of each other. When we took a Saddam out of the scene, now Saudi Arabia is scared. As you can see, what I wrote on here, the Persian Empire, version 3, because you had the original Persian Empire that the Greeks fought, Macedonians and Alexander the Great fought. And then you have the Parthians that the Romans fought. And now you have just Iran. But they are establishing a Shiite crescent. If you Google Shiite Crescent, you'll see exactly what it is. I did my best there, but it basically would start here to see. This is the Persian Gulf right here. We have a carrier battle group stationed in Bahrain, which ironically is semi-allied with Iran. This would be the Shiite Crescent leading out into the Mediterranean Sea, which dangerous for us. Now, who's fighting against the Shiite Crescent? Saudi Arabia is leading the charge. There were recently war games held in Egypt that included contingents of troops from Saudi Arabia, Oman, United Arab Emirates, not Qatar, because Qatar's on, they're beefing right now with the Gulf states. And they recently held war games, and that was seen as a prelude to a Middle Eastern NATO type of a deal. And that was intimidating for Iran. But have you heard about the war in Yemen between the Houthi rebels and the government? Or the what was the government? The Houthi rebels are an extension of Iran. Iran has been supplying them and helping them because they want to open up Saudi Arabia's southern flank so that southern so that Saudi Arabia doesn't basically have its own peninsula here. They want to make it uneasy, open up their flank, cause unrest, etc. Now, a big point that I'm going to make clear regarding Iraq. Iran essentially controls Iraq, both politically and militarily. Politically, they've bought off the Iraqi parliament, or their version of it. Most of their candidates are have substantial financial ties to Iran. Al-Sadr's army, Al-Sadr, Muqtada Al-Sadr, his party's gaining traction. We fought pitched battles with him in 2004, the United States did, inside of Iraq. The Syrian civil war is ongoing. The Iranians have about, well, they won't say, but there are mass Iranian contingents fighting Iranian troops. And brings us a little Israel right here. Israel's saying no, because what Iran's been doing is they've been setting up permanent military installations here in Syria. They're using their assistant force, whatever you want to call it, the Iranian troops, including Iranian generals, and the Quds Force, which is responsible for foreign operations. They're fighting in Syria, and Israel has been, they've launched over well over 100 airstrikes against Iranian targets, either with Iran trying to move equipment to its proxy Hezbollah in Lebanon, or those permanent military installations that I was talking about that Iran was building. See, up until now, if you look at the map, you've had a pretty good distance from Israel and Iran. Israel here, and you have Iran. Well, there's suddenly a bunch of Iranian bases here. That's right next to Israel. So Israel's saying no. And they've bombed, and they one time they used bunker busters. Such a strong bombardment over an Iranian provocation. They said the Israelis said that they destroyed about 93% of the Iranian infrastructure, military infrastructure inside of Syria. And those bunker busters initially neighboring countries and the news media thought that Israel had used a low-yield nuclear weapon because one of their bombing campaigns inside Syria targeting Iran caused an earthquake. is of those bunker busters. So the Shiite Crescent, led by Iran, is this, pushing out into the Mediterranean. It also establishes a land bridge between Iran and their foreign proxies. We have troops inside of Iraq. We have a publicly declared 6,500. Inside Syria, we have a publicly declared 2,500. Most of those are special operations troops, like forward air controllers and stuff like that. Don't forget Afghanistan. We have about 10,000, 11,000 troops in Afghanistan. In Saudi Arabia, I'm sure we have contingents there. They're untested in battle. The Iranians have been fighting inside of Syria for years now. Iranian troops in uniform. They've also recruited the popular mobilization units, which consists of a large array of militias inside of Iraq. Remember when we were fighting ISIS inside of Iraq? The Iranians use that as a pretext for them to launch what is known as the popular mobilization units, if you Google that. Basically, a bunch of Iranian-led militias, like 100 of them. So there's just like 100,000 guys up in Iraq in the desert. We managed to establish a blocking force right here at one of the 5 border crossings between Iraq and Syria. The United States has a border crossing right there in southern Syria. So that blocks their land bridge. Stopped. Uh-oh. And the United States also has troops throughout eastern, northeastern, eastern, and southeastern Syria, helping the Kurds, better known the army that we're helping of our proxies, the Syrian Democratic Forces. It's like 80 to 90% Kurdish, because they're such good fighters, and then there's a token force of like 10% Arab. And that's another issue, is the Shiite Iran versus the Saudi Arabia. The Saudi Iranian Sunnis and Egyptian Sunnis. Sunni, Iran is Shiite. Iraq is a little bit of a mix. Southern Iraq has Shiites. Damascus is mostly Sunni, but is ruled by Bashar al-Assad. He's a member of the Alawite Shiite minority. But as you can see, Iran poses a clear and present danger. We have troops in Iraq, we have troops in Syria, we have troops in Jordan, and Israel's right here doing its thing. Wild card is Turkey, and obviously Russia. They have a lot of troops and a lot of air assets inside of Syria. And I would Google that if I was you, because it's quite impressive, actually. So the Iranians want to be able to travel through here at will. So basically, Iraq is kind of like a client state of Iran. Same with Syria once this whole mess is over. Turkey's a wild card. Russia's a wild card. Israel's always a wild card. It doesn't matter what's going on. Lebanon is under de facto control of Hezbollah, which is an Iranian military proxy and political party that also has bases in Venezuela. And those guys look kind of Spanish, and they're probably sneaking up through the border. So any kind of a war, and again, the Persian Gulf is so vital, and you see what Iran wants. The Iranians are Persians. Saudis, you know, they're Arab. These are Persians. These are Arab. I don't like to be referred to as Arabs. I hate that. But the Persian Gulf, like I said, the United States has a battle group here, an aircraft battle group, and we do drills through here. And Iran regularly sends out fast attack boats, like 12 of them. We'll be doing drills, say, like right here, right at the mouth of the entrance here. I think it's called the Strait of Hormuz. We'll have 2 or 3 destroyers doing drills, and then all of a sudden, 12 Iranian fast boats will come out in attack formation and just swarm our guys. And I think we should just line them up, because one tactic to use in warfare is to consistently do military exercises, and then one day those military exercises turn out not to be military exercises. So one day those 12 ships, these little machine gun, they're just little speedboats with machine guns and small cannons on them. One of these days, those swarmings here in the Persian Gulf, it's going to bring down a few battleships, and there's going to be a major war with Iran, but that won't be for a long time. In the 1980s, we fought a brief naval and air skirmish with Iran in the Persian Gulf. We destroyed a couple of their oil platforms, and we destroyed 80% of their air force. Their air force is aging. The only thing that Iran has going for it are its missile defense, its missile program, its anti-air, its ATAK capabilities, anti-air missile, precision missile, and its ground troops, who have received extensive experience fighting inside of Syria, and Hezbollah from Lebanon, who has moved thousands and thousands of troops into Syria years ago. And Israel just launched a operation to clear tunnel systems from Lebanon, controlled by Hezbollah, that were leading into Israel, very complex tunnel systems. So that's a basic overview of the Shiite Crescent, what the United States is doing to combat it. All right, this is Jody Roundhouse. Please subscribe, please like, please comment. Oh, I'm going to give a shout out to Prussia. Yeah.